Hi, I'm Wade Wingler with the Indata Project at Easter Seals Crossroads in Indiana. Today we have a bonus edition of our Tech Tip videos. We have one of the brand new, just a few hours out, iPad 2 devices from Apple. So we're going to take a quick look at it and talk about some future implications and possibilities for folks with disabilities. So for the past year or so, we have been pretty excited about this device, which is an iPad 1, and we have learned that it can be used for a lot of different things. It has a built-in screen reader, you can get augmentative communication software for it. There's just a lot of great stuff that'll let you use an iPad. Well, just a few days ago, this little dude here was released, which is an iPad 2. This is a brand new device. It's just been out for a few days, and the first thing you'll notice is it's a lot thinner than the original iPad. It also has a faster processor, operates more quickly, has a cool little snap-on magnetic case here that allows you to just flip it up, fold it. You can use it standing up in sort of a movie watching kind of mode. You can also turn it around and use that as a typing stand so that you can type that way. One of the things that I'm most excited about, however, with the iPad 2 is that it has a front-facing and a rear-facing camera. And that's going to have some really significant implications for folks with disabilities. Now, in just a second, I'm going to show you what I think might be happening with the world of iPad 2 and a concept called augmented reality. So we're going to step outside for just a minute. I'm going to show you kind of what I think might be coming down the pike with this device. All right, so we are outside of Easter Seals Crossroads on this chilly late spring day, but I want to talk to you about the possibilities of augmented reality with an iPad. So right now, what I've got is this iPad, and these things have cameras built in. And you can see, and we're going to turn around here so you can see outside, where this, if you imagine this is like holding up a blank picture frame, and you're looking through this picture frame, and what you're going to see here are some of the buildings nearby Easter Seals Crossroads. There are manufacturers developing applications that can rely on the cameras, the GPS, and the gyroscope built into the iPad 2. And imagine if you had an application and said, well, I wonder what this building is right here. Well, with the GPS and the gyroscope, it can tell where you are, where you're pointing, and it's kind of like you're looking through this imaginary picture frame with computer overlay. So it might say this is a Superior Insurance Group building and this is visiting nurse, and that can also be combined with a GPS program to say, well, how do I get there? And imagine, if you will, a GPS map that just threw down a green line to follow, or perhaps footsteps, or a way for you to drive your car or ride your bicycle so that you could then have GPS live on the fly. So that's a concept of augmented reality applications that's being developed. It can be used for finding a restaurant. It could be used to help a college student with cognitive challenges to learn to navigate campus. With augmented reality applications, there are tons of possibilities, and I think this device is going to help us get part of the way there. So that's your bonus tech tip for this week. I'm Wade Wingler with the Indata Project in Indiana.